meet in Jamaica his senior year, running 44.93.
In junior year.
And he did it in high school.
Very even out of the blocks. Malik Curley already behind. That lane three is so tight, though I'm sure he trains at it here at Texas A&M. Right now it is looking, though, like Ricky Morgan Jr. of USC trying for the pole. But there comes Akeem Bloomfield, just sort of shifted and got himself in position. These SEC runners so familiar with how to run these indoor tracks because they do it basically every week during the winter.
21.32 seconds for his first 200 meters. Wow.
Curley into second place, but he's had to use so much energy on that first lap. Strother now on the inside. It's going to be Bloomfield. Here comes Curley on the outside. Bloomfield, for whatever reason, letting up at the tape in a race where you've got to qualify on time, and runs 45.64. That's probably going to be good enough. But one wonders sometimes with two more races to run.
Well,
Curley wins it and actually gets the win at the lead. There's Bloomfield in the all blue for Auburn.
Out of lane three, Curley gets a lifetime best. What a tip of the hat that is. Now, Bloomfield torches a 21.3. Very few guys ever run the first 200 faster. He drifts out into lane two, mistake number one. Curley, who's been a good 800 meter runner a couple of years ago, is strong down the home stretch. Strother, I mentioned, has toughness late in the race, looking to move up on the inside. And, you know, I guess he just figured, Dwight, I'm going to get number one, but I'm not sure. Did he get? No, Curley outleaned him by less than a thousandth of a second. So he will automatically go in, but you don't do this. Good grief.
I mean, this is all on time, folks. I can't stress this.